sublime. My life now is sweet. My joy is complete. Because I'm saved. I'm saved. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come now, God, asking for your mercy. Asking for your grace, God. It's a time of need, God, and we need you now like never before. Touch now, God, and anoint in the name of Jesus. You know what it is, God. You know what it needs to be. Put us now, God, where we need to be. Search my heart, God. Touch in the name of Jesus. Strengthen, God. Strengthen me now, God. To preach your word. Preach to Christine. That she might preach to the people. Bless me, God. That I may bless your people. Encourage me, God. That I may encourage your people. We come now, God, because we have a need today. We need to hear your word. And we need a word from heaven. We want you now, God, to do what you do best. Anoint us now. Lift us up, God. And then make us whole. We come to celebrate life. And that more abundantly. God, I come because you asked me to. You chose me, God, to be the one to tell the world about your son. So it's telling time now, God. We want to be a blessing. So we thank you. Oh, God, we thank you. God, I feel my help. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted in thy sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In your name we do pray. Amen. 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 We certainly give God glory and praise for this day. Whew. I'm glad I came, y'all, but it sure ain't no secret I didn't want to come. It's a blessing, God. I thank God. Thank God we give honor to God, your pastor. Amen. We thank God for Pastor Fleming. Amen. I told him I wouldn't bother him because his mother's here. Miss Near Cleese. Amen. That I catch you later. Amen. We thank God for elect Lady Sandra Fleming, the fragrance of the house. We thank God for her. Thank God for all these preachers. Amen. 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 We thank God for the Claxton preachers who went to religious school together. Amen. We just thank God for them. Thank God for this choir. When I worked at A.D. Hill and went to another school to be a one-on-one assistant, and the secretary walked out and the principal put me in the office, and Sister Cheryl walked me through for 2 years. Thank God for it. Amen. She's a good dictator on the telephone. Amen. Maybe I'm just that good. Amen. Thank you. Thank God for Sister Cheryl. She helped me make it through. The next to the last year of my history for Shelby County School. All right. We thank God for my sister. Amen. That's my mother's oldest daughter. Now the youngest and oldest in the middle have gone on to meet the Lord. So we're the two that are left. And I thank God that for the love and the sharing that not only will she come that she wants to hear me, but she'll introduce me And that's a blessing that the family can get along to that area. Amen. Give us a hand. That's a free lesson that you know, because some of you all don't speak to your siblings. All right. Unless you raise your hand, but some of you don't even speak. Amen. We thank God for my two road dogs who are here today. I'm going to side with you. And Cora Sue Smith. Of course, we had a birthday yesterday. God bless you, Sister Cora Sue. But we just thank God for our blessing. I'm struggling with asthma, y'all. Asthma is trying to find a new home, and we kind of moved in my body, but I evicted it. We just slowed by packing the stuff up. I put him out, but he's a little slow by packing his bag. But you know, amen, there's no room here. There is a good word from the Lord today. Y'all just looking at me. We thank God for one of my supporters, Brother Freddie Creek, that I saw in the audience. But I know y'all wanted to share some preach, but I'm the new rock mate. And so y'all, those of you who heard about the rock they got at the women's conference, I'm a rock mate. And no, I don't have any other rocks. Okay. But we thank God for the rock, but I did bring you a rock. Amen. It's just not canceled today, but there is a word from the Lord that the Lord has given me to share with you. I'm not really, really good at theme preaching, but that's not my thing. But I looked at it, and I thought about with so much that's going on in the family. And so I'm wearing this bracelet here for Family's Matter. And I looked at that on my arm the other night, Pastor, and I said, you know what, I'm going to preach that. Because we need to hear who we're looking for. And I brought you a description for today. So if it's not for you, then it's going to be for somebody that you know. But the theme is, who can find a virtuous woman out of Proverbs 31, 10 through 31. And you heard most of the reading all day. So let me read this verse 10. Who can find a virtuous woman, for her price is far above rubies? Then verse 30 says, favor is deceitful, but beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord shall be praised. So give her of the fruit of her hand, and let her own works praise her in the gates. Look back at 31, says, and let her own works praise her in the gates. I want to talk to us today about the proof is in the pudding.
All right.
The proof is in the pudding.
Right.
Book of Proverbs opens with a warning about evil women, but it closes with a description of a godly woman. Everything about this woman is praiseworthy. Look at her hands. She's a willing worker, and her work is fruitful. She cooks, she sews, she manages real estate, and even plants a garden. Her family needs nothing, and she is generous to the poor.
Right.
Sound like Big Mama, doesn't it?
Right.
She does everything. Big Mama had a little garden that didn't grow in the yard, and grew a little pot on the porch.
Right.
She would always find something. You would never go there, and there was not food on the table. She managed to feed us and the neighborhood. But she had a way of making ends meet. Then she was crafty because she could sew. She could stitch together anything. We had two horses in the front yard with some plaques across the top of them. Come on, y'all, that's been there 50 years. And Big Mama would lay out there and take all those scrap pieces that she got from the dry goods store. Yeah, I'm home over the hill. From the dry goods store. That's where you go up there and you buy everything but meat.
Right.
And she would take those pieces of fabric and put them across those two, three planks, and then put them together and start sticking together. And what would she make, y'all? That quilt. She had a way of making everything work. She was good at real estate. She could fix up the house like never before. She could make ends meet. I remember walking through my grandma's house when she passed away, and Daddy gave me the keys, and I was trying to find the closet, and in the back room was some great big nails on the wall. I said, well, there's a closet here. She had